Good morning. I thought I would do something a little bit different. I usually vlog this rather than vlog it, but I haven't really daily vlogged last week, so I thought I would do something a little bit different instead. So today is my July favourites and a couple of Empties chucks in there as well. But hey, let's get started. So first up are these. You've probably seen these lots of times. They're just the Real Techniques brushes, and these are the Duo Fiber collection. These were sold as a pack. I bought them from Amazon when they were on deal, so they were really cheap. I think they were like half price. So you get the face brush, which is pretty much a general purpose brush. You'll see me buffing my foundation with it, put on bronzer with it, blusher, even do a bit of contouring, loose contouring, very natural. It's just generally a pretty good brush and needs a bit of a clean actually, but it's pretty good. Is the contour brush. Again, for contouring, so for this I would do the 3 from my forehead down to my cheekbone and under my chin. I don't really do all that much contouring. I prefer just to highlight my cheekbones, my nose, and the tip of my forehead, but if I was to do much, I would use this. And this is probably my favourite. It's the eye brush. When I first got it, I wasn't too keen because I prefer a closer brush, so a lot shorter hair brush. You can see the bristles are quite long, and I wasn't too keen, but actually it holds the shadows really well, and then it blends it really nicely. It's especially good for the crease into your socket, and blending it out that way. So it's a pretty good brush. So all in all, they were good. Concealers. So my usual go-to drugstore concealer is the Rimmel London Wake Me Up Concealer, and I can't tell you what number it is because it's worn out, the label's gone out. But I do find this a funny texture to blend, although it conceals really well, the coverage is really good. However, I was in Pound World the other week picking up some laundry bits and pieces and cleaning bits, and I saw the new collection called Miss Beauty London. Obviously everything is around, and part of me just thought, I just want to try some bits out of interest, and it's a pound, so why not? I had no expectations for it because I just thought it's cheap and it's a pound, but it's really good. I bought the light one, which is number one. It's the lightest one they did, and just on a little sponge applicator, and it is great for lightening up under my eyes. I actually really, really like this product. It is a thick texture and it does take some working in, but it's really, really good. I wouldn't use this for blemishes like around my chin or somewhere because it would just be too light. So I will stick to this probably. I will replace this one and get some more of that. But for under your eyes and for highlighting, like here, and across your nose, and mainly around my eyes, this is really good, and it was a pound, so can't complain. They had a massive range of products, so maybe I'll try a few more. But I am always a little bit wary, although it is a pound, so have you got to lose. And that is the Matte Effect Foundation from Makeup Revolution. Again, a really, really cheap drugstore alternative to my usual Estee Lauder. Just one that, you know, I thought I would try. This is in natural, it's empty, so I can't show it you. But it's just one of those type bottles. Coverage is really light. For me, it's more like a tinted moisturiser, but it's really good and it does the job and it really is matte. Great for just everyday mummy makeup, shoving on, bit of mascara, a bit of blusher, and on one away. So I won't actually be replacing this because I've done a Makeup Revolution order and they've got a new foundation, so I'll try that, but I won't tell you what it is just yet. One that I love, drugstore alternative, is Scandalize Retro Glam by Rimmel. If you've watched my recent videos, then you'll know I bought the Benefit Roller Lash, which I love, but I don't find it gives enough volume. It gives the length and the curl and the lift, but I use this on top if I want that exaggerated lash. And actually, this is really good for everyday makeup. It's a massive brush, which is the only issue, because I end up getting it up here on my socket and on my nose always. But it's really, really black and it's really good. You can't go wrong. So yeah, I'll be replacing that. The other one you'll have seen if you watched my holiday haul, that I bought some BarryM makeup. Always use their nail products and never use their makeup. Some of the makeup I bought from that haul was a little bit disappointing. But again, it's really cheap, so I'm not complaining. But this Flawless Matte Finish foundation is really, really good. I got it in nude too. And again, this is just a really, really good, cheap, everyday foundation. I've still got quite a bit to go. It's definitely a favourite. A few more things to show you. First of all, Batiste hairspray, dry shampoo. This is a little one that I've had in my handbag and it's empty. I didn't want to keep the big one. I actually bought the big floral and fruity blush version and also a mini because I love the smell of that. I don't know why I do that, I can't even smell it because it's empty. But there you go. Batiste is nothing new on my dressing table or my handbag. I use it all the time, so of course I will be replacing this. Love it. Next up is a hand cream from Crabtree and Evelyn, and this is the Caribbean Island Wildflowers. I get really, really dry hands, so I'm always on the hunt for a good hand cream. I lose them quite a lot, so I replace them a lot. This is quite a big one though, so this is staying on my dressing table. I'm not planning on taking this anywhere. This is new. It's definitely a favourite. It smells amazing. I was lucky enough to be sent this and I love it, and I'm embarrassed by this packet. Is water wipes. Any mums out there will know what water wipes are. They do great baby wipes. But these are actually makeup removal wipes. Now, I'm not a lover of makeup wipes, removal wipes, because I find they just move your makeup around your face rather than taking it off. Or you really have to scrub, and that's really not good for your skin. But these were in a box that I received ages ago, a subscription box. Or I had another packet before this anyway, and I repurchased them, because I found these really, really good. Basically, they're fragrance-free, alcohol-free, and they're available for daily use. And in them, it's basically all natural and pure. So there's water, citrus extract, and myrcel, which is sea mineral extract. So really, really good. We've been camping recently, and we're going again. And also when I've been working away in Europe and only taking hand luggage, I can't take everything that I want to take. So instead of makeup remover, I've been taking these and they've been really good. They've not dried out, they don't sting. Sometimes when I'm removing my makeup with other wipes, my eyes really hurt and they're really sensitive and I really wouldn't recommend. But these are really good and they're great just to have to chuck in your away bag, or just have those really lazy nights, and we all have them, don't tell me you don't, where you just really can't be bothered to remove your makeup. There's really no excuses with these. So that's that. So that is that for this month. I hope you've enjoyed it. I've done a big Makeup Revolution order, so I will share that with you soon. I might blog that though, instead of videoing it. Yeah, so I'll see you soon. Bye.